from Warsenal Studio B in Chandler, Arizona, this is MayaCast. Welcome to another edition of MayaCast. I'm your host, Tom Shadle.
I'm your host, Kip Harsell.
And this is episode 342 for Friday, October 8th, 2021. Prize-winning memes. Coming up on today's show, we are going to be giving out a bunch of prizes. We've got the September Patreon winners coming up real quick here, and then we've got the conclusion of our quarter three meme painting contest. And so we've got all of the winners for that. So if you want to follow along, go over to Facebook. We've got a pinned post with the gallery of everybody's entries of their pin and miniatures that they then had to turn into a meme. And so we had 49 entries, which is great. And congratulations to everyone who entered. Y'all did an amazing job. So we're going to talk about that today. But first, like I said, we have September's Patreon winners. Patreon is a service that allows you to support the show so that we can keep paying our hosting fees and shipping out prizes and all of that good stuff. And so if you're interested in helping support the show, you can go to patreon.com/MayaCast to get all of the details. And then if you sign up to do that, you're in the running every month to win cool prizes. We have three tiers, and the light infantry tier wins any infinity blister of your choice, and the medium infantry tier is any infinity box set of your choice, and then the heavy infantry tier is custom infinity artwork sketched by Florian Stitz to your specifications, whatever it is that you would like. And so we have those three winners from the month of September. And Kip?
Yep.
Who's our light infantry winner of any infinity blister that they want?
That would be a Mr. Nate Raleigh. Yay!
So Nate, just let us know whatever blister you want. Send us your shipping address, and we will get it out to you. And then the medium infantry, which is any infinity box set of normal size, that is going to be Mr. Michael Strauss.
Yay!
Again, send us an email, let us know what box set you want, and your shipping address, and we'll get that to you. And finally, the heavy infantry, the custom artwork by Florian Stitz, infinity-themed to whatever you want, is...
I find it funny that Florian Stitz is going to have to draw a picture for one Steve Schmidt from Utah, because they are both German.
And we just had a Strauss, too.
Oh, we did?
So, yeah, Strauss, Schmidt, and Stitz. But, yeah, congratulations to Steven Schmidt on winning his custom Infinity sketch from Florian. So that's awesome. So, guys, just email us at tom@mayacast.com.
And kip@mayacast.com.
And let us know what prize you want and your shipping address, and we will get those out to you. And, like I said, patreon.com/mayacast if you want to learn more about how you can help support the show. So with all of that out of the way, it is 1 month until Arizona Armageddon five. And so
my bag, I can't count the badges.
There are still some slots. It is a fully vaccinated event. So if you feel like coming down to Arizona the first weekend of November when it's gonna be like room temperature outside, Then you could still do that. There's a Arizona Armageddon group on Facebook that you can search for and find out to get the dates and information. Or you can contact Tim Adair if you know how to do that. Facebook, likely. But yeah, so let's get into the third quarter meme contest stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen, the MayaCast Masterclass.
All right, so we had our quarter three contest. The theme was meme. You could paint any single miniature, any single infinity miniature you wanted, and paint it up real nice, and then create a meme using that miniature in your meme. And we had 49 entries, and there were some pretty good memes, man.
Mm-hmm.
Some pretty good memes. That Padme Amidala meme got some good run. I think we had 3 or 4 entries based on that meme. The Stormtrooper one was good.
I was just going to say that's the one I'm staring at right now because, A, I like when you can bring Star Wars and Infinity together.
Mm-hmm.
It's always fun.
Still BS-14, right?
Yeah, but that is amazing.
Yeah, that was Gingle?
Yep, Gingle. Or Gingle.
Jingle? All the way? Sorry, Barry. That was Barry G. And so, cool head swap, bro. Mm-hmm. And if you're going to be doing more of these, we hope you share all of them with us. You can get on the MayaCast forum on Facebook and post pictures whenever you finish one up, because we do like the Star Wars mashups.
Oh, yeah.
But the Rick and Morty meme.
So not only was that one of my favorite painted miniatures out of the whole thing, when I actually got to the meme, I died. You best butter. that one was really, really good. But yeah, the model itself is absolutely one of my favorite of all of the entries.
Oh, yeah.
Bastion.
Bastion Vogelsberg, once again, did a really great job. Love all the weathering, mm-hmm. the little chips and the scratches, right, that he does. The lighting effect on the eye, that yellow glow, I thought was mm-hmm. real cool. But then I noticed that the eyepiece itself is red.
Red.
Bastion, you're killing me. Does a real good job with his edge highlights, right? He's always in the top every masterclass. Really, really good piece out of Bastion there.
Mm-hmm.
I meant to talk about the memes first, but it's just like going right into talking about the
I always screwed up, man.
Appropriating the model.
The models, yeah.
Oh my gosh! So So Lonely by the Police. With the wild parrot, mm-hmm. because it does. He looks so sad.
He does.
Sad little wild parrot. That broke my heart.
I didn't even realize that until I saw that, that it does kind of just sit there looking like it's crying into a cup of coffee.
That would have been a great pass the butter meme.
Yes, yes. I agree.
What is my purpose? One thing I thought that was really sweet that I liked was that Chris and Mickey Kornfeld did Zalamandra,
mm-hmm.
but he did the new one and she did the old one. And so then they both did the same meme, but they swapped positions. And it's like the Spider-Man pointing at Spider-Man.
Oh, yeah, that's funny.
So I thought that was really sweet that husband and wife did the same model and then just swapped positions, but did the same meme.
Mm-hmm.
That was pretty clever. Maybe my favorite is the Pablo Escobar one. The Spetsnaz sniper waiting to make it into a list. And so you just replace Pablo Escobar's head with the Spetsnaz head. The sad, lonely, waiting. Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
That was real good. Octavia Grimm's daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Which, another one of the top painted pieces in this competition, painted by James Matthews. Missile launcher, super sweet, real nice blends and edges, right?
Mm-hmm.
Missile launcher is what does it for me, though.
Yeah, the fades on that are really, really good.
But and then the meme is like the, oh wow, this is worthless, and because I mean, yeah, it's funny.
One of the ones that cracked me up because it's a little bit before that is the Taiga, but then it didn't qualify because the model's not in there, but he's got the football player that's like, how many Taigas will I take? And it was likely number 4.
Mm-hmm.
And then the one that's like, welp. Yeah, the 40. Welp.
you heard of Elf on a Shelf? Now we've got Orc on a Fork.
Yes, that was ridiculous.
again, like you can follow along in the gallery as you listen if you want to, because a lot of these are pretty great. Nauf, I think it was Nauf. Yeah, it's Nauf. I get my comic book characters mixed up. But Nauf, it's like, you only need 15 models to play Infinity.
Yeah.
And there's Nauf in his like 100 models. That he's got all trade up. I thought that was funny.
That is good.
The Fassbender as Magneto perfection meme with show me the Ariadne hacker. No, the real Ariadne hacker. And then it's the tank hunter. And he's like, perfection.
You know which one that I did like from earlier was, I thought it was funny, was he was like, retaking an exam. Why don't you just retake? It's like the Knighthead from Saladin. He's like, never mind.
I thought you'd like the other
Saladin one
because it's based on Kingdom of Heaven.
Getting there.
Okay.
That's the one I'm on right now, yes. Of course I'm going to love that one. That is amazing.
That's playing to your audience right there.
Oh, yes, that is.
It's like Kip likes Kingdom of Heaven, does he?
Hmm.
Yes, it's that one is amazing. Well done, too, to find the perfect pictures for that.
Casanova, where Liz Lemon's like, why are you wearing a tux? He's like, it's after six. Where am I? A Conte Cimento? Which is great 30 Rock meme.
See, I've never watched 30 Rock, so that's probably why I didn't get it. But I did like the other Casanova one where he's like,
replace Casanova with Alec Baldwin. And
oh, okay. Perfect. No, like the one that was like, I'm on the list, right?
Yeah.
Were there like the drop ships ready?
Yeah.
Yeah. You didn't like that?
Well, oh, no. It's, I was shaking my head because no, you're not on the list.
Yeah, exactly. No. Sorry. You don't even like your model that much.
The Layla Sharif, where it's the change my mind desk guy.
Yes.
Where it says, nobody can twist around like that and shoot a rifle. Change my mind. And then he's there with his brain spotted out on the ground.
Yes.
I especially enjoy that because I really hate that meme.
Yes. I agree.
It's just got such a arrogant, like aggressive attitude, that meme. Mm-hmm. It's like, you know,
wait.
Nobody can argue at this point.
Yeah.
Right.
Now, I do love Stop Hammer Time. Because.
Ding, 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 ding.
Yeah, it's just. Ding, ding, ding. I was like, well played. I like that one. Although the Layla one is one of my absolutely top favorite ones because that was just really funny.
And then possibly the best thing is the meme made out of Cody in his unicorn suit.
That one is fantastic.
And so Josh Nordstrom provided that, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he needs to make a blank version of that meme.
Yeah, right? That's
so that
true.
Everyone can use it for whatever they want. That would be my call.
That is funny.
Those are the memes that stood out to me.
The other one, because this has been my pain. I don't have the whip +3, but I love the one that's the two buttons that gets used a lot. Because it was like succeed at whip +13 or roll 18 six times. Because lately, with my doctor in my U.S. Ariadne, I swear every time I try to roll onto something, I roll an 18. And so that one just... I thought that was funny because I feel your pain.
Well, yeah, we all feel his pain. But yeah, and I guess the sheer amount of work that went into Killian's meme. It wasn't a meme; it was a full page of full comic book page with Ada Swanson.
Oh yeah.
But yeah, so good job, guys! You made us laugh, and. You made other people laugh as well. Lots of good comments and likes going up. So that's all good. People are enjoying it.
Yeah, these are all really good.
So, models. Ben Counters Saladin. Saladin.
Yes.
I really, really like the skin tone. Right? He looks Middle Eastern. And that's, you know, but it also, it goes up to a really nice bright highlight as skin is shiny and reflects light, right? But you just keep those areas really small so the overall effect is darker. I just really like the Middle Eastern feeling that we got, that he got on that face.
Mm-hmm.
The sword's really good. It's like energy sword. And then the details, like the stripes on the chest armor,
mm-hmm.
I thought were really good. So
I'm a sucker for that. Like that cream color with the added like darker like stripes you put on there, right?
Mm-hmm.
I love that. I don't know why that pops to me so much, but it does. I like it a lot.
Mm-hmm. Feel free to jump in with whatever you want, or else I'm just going to keep going down my list.
No, you're good.
Corey McCullough did a Spetsnaz sniper, the aforementioned Pablo Escobar Spetsnaz sniper. But I just really like the color scheme.
Mm-hmm.
I really like the blue that he's got going on. And again, the stripes, you said it gets you.
Yeah, it does, because that was the other one that I was like, that is really, really good, and it pops so well.
The red and white stripe across the blue shoulder pad. He almost looks like a Marvel character with the black pants and then the blue armor with the red and white stripe. Captain Spetsnaz.
One of our repeat offenders, Dawid Kepa.
Mm-hmm.
I really freaking like his cell shading on that ninja.
Mm-hmm.
He does it really well. And I said it every time somebody does it very well. It's something that I've wanted to attempt to do and just haven't got around to it. But his always looks really good. Like, this is amazing.
Yeah, it's pretty dope. And then especially when he drops it into that background.
Yeah, it just fits.
Then it really looks like a comic, a cartoon. But, cell shading, really sweet. Hans Schmutz did a war core that was very striking.
Mm-hmm.
A very stark black and red scheme. Evil war core.
Yeah.
And just a really good job with the scheme and his highlights and stuff. And really, really nice. Like Bastion, he took his pictures on a black background.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that really, like, that's very smart of Bastion, because it really makes it pop more,
mm-hmm.
Contrast better. So really smart to do an entry like that. And same thing here with Hans and his war core.
It pulls you in on this model a lot, because that one, like, you immediately, your eyes want to jump to it. I did want to give a little cred to Greg Edwards. Because I don't, there's something about that like pastel teal and gold on Andromeda, which Andromeda is one of my favorite models in the entire line, and her profile's not too shabby either.
It's one way of putting it.
I know, right? I there was something about that I really liked. That I haven't seen one like that before, so kudos.
I already talked about James Matthews Octavia, right?
Yes, he did.
Back when we did the meme portion. Well, once again, James, good job.
Yeah, right.
Sweet missile launcher, bro. So then on to Killian, who did Aida Swanson. This is another one of the top entries this month in my book. And I really dig the skin tones he got. Where it's not just, you know, one color highlighted and shaded. He's using tones and things and really cool stuff there. The silver armor plates. Well, NMM silver. The gray armor plates. But yeah, his armor plates really well done. That little gleam on the front of the magazine.
Yeah.
That you get in that front view there. And so he's got like a digital urban camouflage.
Mm-hmm.
But then some of the panels are red. Which just, to me, struck me as really fitting, like, a combined army character.
Yeah, right.
Right? So I thought that was a really cool detail. Jeans and hiking boots. You know, she's blending in.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, no, I really, really enjoyed Killian's Aida Swanson.
Yeah.
Another great job out of Killian.
He did a really good job on those fades.
He crushes it every quarter.
Yeah, he does. And, I agree with everything Tom said. Like, just your everything is really smooth about it, and I do like that he used the tones on the skin. And you know what? I'm a really big fan of her new profile, especially in Drew's. So kudos on that as well.
What is it you like about it?
Her profile?
Yeah.
Her getting the 4 deployment, mimetism, having the plus 1 burst on the submachine gun. It's really good. I've used her as like a suppression piece because of her mimetism.
Mm-hmm.
And then she also has viral mines.
Yeah.
So that helps. but being up in the fort, and she's not that expensive, so
it's like 23.
Yeah, so it's, I don't know, like Tim's like, you should try her out, and because I kept kind of overlooking her, and as I've tried her, I was like, yep, she's really good. Like the last game I played, I had to go second in acquisition, and that's a 16 inch deployment zone, so she's out there like 20 inches. So I put her right in the middle in this corridor and use a command token to put her in suppression fire to start the game off, and to get to her, you had to be within 24 inches. So it was really good. I think she's a solid profile piece for that. So totally dig her profile in Drews.
What?
So I wanted Chris Marland took one of my least favorite models of all time and made it interesting to me. That is Casanova. I just, maybe he's pandering to his audience. It's black and orange, my cast colors. But yeah, it looks really interesting. I got by that. I was like, that's nice. Really like the color palette that you chose.
Yeah, it's a dope outfit.
Super, super sick. And I can't stand that model.
And not an easy color to get that smooth.
Not at all.
Of a yellow, orange.
Mm-hmm.
Then nice. McCallop did a tank hunter, and I'm sad that he only sent in one picture plus the meme, because I would like to see it from a few different angles. And just the one word, McCallop. I really dig the gray like helmet and shoulder pad, the gray armor stuff. But again, I want to see it from different angles. I like that she is conscientiously wearing a mask to protect herself and others. But the mask is red, and it's the only red thing there, right? So yeah. It pops out, draws attention to the face like you want to do. And so, no, I really, there's only the one picture, but I really enjoyed it.
Yeah, it was really good. I'm a sucker for grays too, though.
Good gray, yeah. Like a Mickey Hansen 012 gray.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice.
Yeah, it makes me, like, my Drews have that soft gray on there, man, and I'm really leaning towards bringing them to Armageddon instead of US, because I can actually play with a almost fully painted army.
Okay, so let's give out some prizes.
Yeah.
We've got, we're going to give away two blister packs and two box sets. And remember, for quarter four, the more entries we get, the more prizes we give away. So get your friends to enter and participate, and we can give away even more stuff when we have even more entries.
Yay.
So the first blister, and these are all randomly selected by random.org. We had 49 entries, so we tell it to pick a number from 1 to 49. We do that four times. We've got four prize winners. The first blister is going out to Jeremy Wong.
Yeah.
So,
congratulations, Jeremy.
And to all of these winners coming up here, let us know what prize you want. And in this case, it's a blister, any Infinity blister that you want. And send us your shipping address along with the prize that you want. And you email that to tom@mayacast.com.
And kip@mayacast.com.
And so the first one, Jeremy Wong, congratulations. You won a blister.
Good job, man. Second, we actually mentioned this person already. So not only did we like some of his work, but random.org apparently did as well, because his number came up, and that is going to A1, and this is a blister, any blister of your choosing. It's going to A1 Bastian Vogelsberger.
What?
Yeah.
All right, congratulations, Bastian. And the first box set, this is another person we've already mentioned. This is going to the man with one name, McCallop. Has won a box set.
I kind of want to do that scene from Braveheart. Chalik. McCallop. And they all start chanting it. That's what, so if you've seen that, McCallop.
McCallop.
That's what's going through McCallop. Our head right now.
McCallop.
And everybody starts cheering.
McCallop.
McCallop. And for our final box set, any box set of your choosing is going to go to a Stefan Raditz. So congratulations, Stefan, and to all the other random.org winners.
So Stefan, McCallop, Bastian, Jeremy, let us know what you want. Make sure you include a shipping address, Tim Tulin, and we will get those prizes out to you as soon as we get them in. That just leaves the winner of the MayaCast Master Glass itself. And the memes were fun and funny, and we enjoyed them. It's not part of the contest, though. The contest is, this is still a painting contest, yeah, is the deal. And so we had, we whittled it down to a top four and then a top three, and then it was really, really hard to take those top three and choose one because they're all so good. Mm-hmm. And the winner of MayaCast Master Glass Quarter 3, 2021, memes, is Killian McKeever.
Yeah.
With his outstanding Aida Swanson. Go check it out on the in the Facebook gallery if you haven't seen it already. So congratulations, Killian. You, sir, win the Master Glass. And that is going to be a custom engraved glass that has the Master Glass logo on it. It's a cool little hacking hollow designed by Tim Tulin. And it will have your name on it. Let us know what you wanted to say. Either Killian McKeever or your... Oh, I think I used to know his ITS name and now I forget.
No.
Or your ITS name or... whatever you want, within reason. And we'll get that engraved for you and shipped all the way over the Atlantic to you.
Yeah, it's going to be a long one.
So, congratulations. Thanks to everyone who participated. That was a fun theme, and you guys had a lot of fun with it. And so, awesome. And thanks to those of you that wrote notes in with your entries. We don't get to respond to all of them, but a lot of notes included with them saying, you know, thanks for the podcast, keep up the good work, or, you know, this has kept me sane or motivates me to, you know, actually get my thing painted.
We like those.
And we're going to try and continue to do that by having a painting contest for quarter four. So we're going to tell you the theme here, but first, I'm going to do my once quarterly description of how to enter the contest.
Yeah, this is the one to pay the most attention to because it's the most clear.
I don't have bullet points. I'm going to wing it like Kip always does.
Yeah.
So the contest will start now and go until the end of the quarter, which actually we go a few days later. So this is going to be like in the first couple of days of January.
Yeah.
So it's nice. You're going to get your whole winter break to do it if you have such a thing, if you get off for the holidays or whatever. You get a little extra time. And this is going to be a single miniature theme. Okay? And I'm going to tell you the theme at the end.
Mm-hmm.
So stay tuned.
Mm-hmm.
But it's going to be a single miniature again. And you all know what it is anyway.
Yeah.
If you took a guess, you were correct. It's going to be a single miniature theme. And we part of the reason we do this contest is so that you'll paint some of that pile of shame, right? You'll get motivated and paint some of your stuff. So we want it to be a new thing, not something you've had lying around painted for a few years, right? We want it to be brand new. And because we want it to be brand new, we ask that you submit a before picture. So that can be a picture of it in the blister, or it can be bare metal, or it can be primed, or maybe you started painting on it a little bit already and forgot to take the before picture. But we want a before picture that is date stamped, right? And so you can put it on your iPad with the date up and then take a picture with your phone. Some people use like that day's newspaper, take a picture on it. Super old school. But anything that shows the date so that, you know, we know that it's a brand new thing you're doing for this contest and you're getting new miniatures painted and on the table, which is awesome. So it's a new miniature. You just started painting it. One thing, when you are done painting it, take some pictures of it. Solid backgrounds work great. They really show off the model nicely. Mm-hmm. We talked about how smart Bastion was to use that black background and Hans, right? How it's just solid. You can focus on the miniature and it makes all of the colors sort of pop and there's more contrast and your eyes focus better.
Mm-hmm.
Or a plain white background, a blue, right, whatever. Paint the miniature, take some pictures. And choose your best four pictures, your four favorite pictures. Some people like to do a collage where they want to show some close-ups of some parts that they're really proud of, extra detail or whatever. And because we only allow four pictures, they'll combine like four or five close-ups into one collage and that'll be one picture. And then the other three pictures are the model from different angles. When you've done that, please go on your computer there and change the name of those pictures to your name. and then a number. So if I were entering this contest, I would name them Tom Shadle 1, Tom Shadle 2, Tom Shadle 3, Tom Shadle 4. You don't need to rename the before picture unless you really want to. It doesn't have to say MayaCast Masterclass Quarter 4 2021 Tom Shadle 1. No, just your name and the number. That really helps us out as we try to organize all of the pictures coming in and get them loaded into galleries. And the file name that you put on these pictures is what you will appear as on Facebook when we post the final gallery, so that you're properly credited for your work. So if you just write McCallop, then it's just McCallop, and that's all we know you as from that point on. So rename your photos with however you'd like to be credited, and so that when we give out prizes, you know it's you, and we know it's you, and we can all figure out who these prizes are supposed to go to. So rename them, and that we Facebook definitely prefers JPEGs and PNGs. Right? Yeah. JPG and PNG. And definitely, it really doesn't like HEIF. Sometimes they go through, sometimes it borks up the entire album and not just your pictures. Mm-hmm. And so, if you could, JPEG or PNG is perfection. And you're going to take those four finished pictures of your model and the one before picture and combine them into one single email. Okay. Please add those files as attachments to the email, rather than pasting them into the body. It makes it easier for us to download into our folders to organize everything. So if you could attach those to an email that you will then send to tom@mayacast.com.
And kip@mayacast.com.
It's a single email. You don't have to send us the before now and then the finished one when you're finished. They can all come together. It's date stamped. We'll see when that picture was taken, right? Your before picture. Not a problem. And then we've got all your pictures, and we put them in a gallery. We put them on Facebook. Everybody gets to enjoy them. And then we do a show where we talk about how awesome your paint jobs were, and we give out blisters and box sets and all of that stuff. So there it is. Mm-hmm. That's how you do MayaCast Masterclass. And you know, people kind of like ask on the internet, like, when are you going to announce it? Well, you announce it on the show because it's a podcast, and the thing that matters are the downloads and the listening to it. So that's why we don't do it as like a blog article or anything. So make sure you listen.
It's like a radio show.
Now, Kip.
Yep.
Tell everybody what the theme for quarter four is, Stunning No One.
The theme, as it rumbles by on the frozen roads of whatever planet we are on, this end of quarter MayaCast theme is straight from your latest episode of Sons of Anarchy, Bikers! That was my best movie voice.
This is a pretty good movie voice.
So anything on a bike. Any model on a bike.
Ice Road Monstruckers.
There you go.
That comes courtesy of Tor Swanson.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, bikes. It's bikes. Any model on a motorbike.
Yeah.
From Aragato. Oh, I should have looked that up before I tried to do that off the top of my head. What's the last alphabet bike rider there is?
The last alphabet bike.
Is there one with a Z?
Because there's the Arigato Sensen Chikobais.
Oh, from Arigato to Zensen Butai, like, amazing. No, but yeah, any model on a bike. Sure, it could be the authorized bounty hunter that you now need to have for 5 out of the 20 missions in the ITS pack. Oh, hold the phone. Remember, we did the ITS show, came out a few days ago,
yeah,
and then at the end we're like, unless it all changed in the week since we recorded, and we'll make no lies detected, no changes to report.
I got worried on that video too when he's like, every table will be
Antarctica.
I was like, oh great, are they gonna change that? Nope.
What he actually meant was that the missions that have that, the whole table is Antarctic terrain.
Super stoked.
Yeah. No changes to be made. Wipe the sweat off the forehead. Woo! Yeah, so, authorized bounty hunter, sure. Or it could just be bikes in your faction, because they get buffs in the Antarctic terrain, right? So, motorbikes is the theme, guys. And I'm sure you're all already planning on one. It's only been like 3 days since the ITS packet dropped, so hopefully you haven't like actually started yet, so you can take a quick before picture. One big thing about the contest that we ask all of the entries is the big gallery of painted models is a cool thing, right? Mm-hmm. And we want all of the models to be fresh for that. We want them to be brand new, things that people have never seen before. So we do ask that you don't share any examples of your entry online anywhere, like in public. You know, ask your friend for painting advice, sure, whatever. But like, don't post it to the Facebook groups or whatever until after the gallery is posted and the contest is over. Because we want everything in that gallery, in that contest gallery, to be the first time people have ever seen it. So that's one thing I forgot to mention. But yeah, it's bikes. Motorbikes. And it's going to be single model. Sorry, you were about to say something.
Yeah, sorry. I was just saying, as of now, it's Arigato to Pentasilea.
Okay.
Because you're like, I don't know what the last one. I was like, off the top of my head, I was like, Penny's probably the
just trying to go through
there.
Motorcycles, finding the
Oh, dude, I'm flying. Last I'm, one. Well, I'm trying to fly.
Yep. From Arigato to Pentasilea.
Technically, it'd be the 112 emergency service
that
to
would
Pentasilea.
Be, that would be, yeah. Sure. But yeah, bikes it is. And I'm sure no one is surprised. We had a couple others lined up, and we thought, you know, this is going to be the best one for right now. And it comes out just after Christmas. We're going to be feeling in a generous Christmas-giving mood.
Oh, yeah.
So hopefully we get tons and tons of entries so that we can give out tons and tons of prizes. Remember, the more entries we get, the more prizes we give away, and you can't win
if you don't play. And I'm going to do a quick update to our Eddie Bike from 112 Emergency Service to every Hawk player out there screaming at us through the radio.
Zuleika
Nazarova. That is...
As soon as you said Hawk, it yeah. popped right in my head.
Zamira and Zuleika, but Zuleika would be the last. So anything from a 112 to Zuleika right now. I'm pretty sure that's the only one that's going to be... we're gonna leave it at that.
So this gallery is gonna be the largest Harley Davidson gallery in the world, which is just funny because every Harley Davidson you see says it's the largest Harley Davidson dealership, and they all mean that for one reason: it's the highest volume in this county. It is the largest square footage in this city. But I swear, everyone you drive by is like, "World's largest Harley Davidson dealership."
That's funny.
In this town.
In this town.
But, so we're going to do the world's largest Harley Davidson gallery. You don't have to make a meme out of it this time, but you can if you want to. And, come play with us. Mm-hmm. Join. Be excellent.
In Japan, we're yelling at me because when I said Penny was the first one I could think of off the top of my head, and they're like, "Yo, Jimbo!"
Yeah.
But Zuleika takes a cake. She is the furthest one. All right. We got our Amazon little thing out of the way, A to Z.
Cool. Right. Quarter four, bikes, and ready, set, go. You're on the
vroom,
clock.
Vroom, vroom.
Conversation can serve no purpose anymore. Goodbye.
All right, so that is going to wrap it up already for episode 342, prize-winning memes. And Kip,
yeah.
You want to tell everybody about MayaCast Masterclass Quarter 4?
Nope, you just did it.
Okay.
Vroom, vroom.
But yeah, so get a before picture taken of that bike and start painting it because you need it for the new ITS season. They come for free, so might as well have one. Thank you for listening, and until next time, get out there, support your local game store. Zzz.
To
find out how you can support the show, go to patreon.com/MayaCast.
You can find us online at www.MayaCast.com.
We are on Facebook at facebook.com/InfinityMayaCast.
Follow at MayaPodcast on Twitter.
Join the MayaCast forum group on Facebook.
And as always, you can email us at tom@MayaCast.com.
And Kip@MayaCast.com.